Yeah, myself is Ravi Kumar. I'm a software engineer. And my first request to my fellow Indians is don't always relate September 11 with the terrorism, because so many things have happened in India. More than 20,000 people have been killed in Kashmir. 2,000 Muslim brothers have been killed in Gujarat. So we have so many incidents to link with terrorism in India itself. Like, we can link December 13 to terrorism, and the day in which Akshardham temple people have entered, that we can link it with the terrorism. I thank Mr. Jagir Nayak for clearing the misconception about the jihad. My question is that you told that just for the sake of one person, you cannot attack the country. Now, I am asking about the imaginary scenario. Suppose I am going to some Arab country, I am causing a great devastation, I am killing lakhs and crores of people there, and I am coming back to the India, and the country is giving a proof to me, proof to Indian government, stating that this person has caused the devastation. And the Indian government is repeatedly telling that proof what is given by you is not valid. And that proof is being shared with the other countries. They all agree. And suppose the country repeatedly is not ready to surrender me, then what is the action that particular country has to take? I have not completed. And another thing is, the proof of that country is previously also when that kidnapped plane entered that, they encouraged the kidnappers, they allowed the terrorists who have come in that plane to escape out of the country. If that is the status of the country, then what is the action that particular country has to take it? You are telling, suppose I have come, after causing a devastation, I have come back to India, Indian government is not ready to surrender me, and the proofs have been given, and Indian government is repeatedly telling the proof what you have given is not valid. What is the action that country has to take?
The brother has asked a very good question, and a very relevant question, a very good analogy between what's happened 11 September again, though he came back to 11 September. Analogy is very good, that he as a person goes and crosses an Arab country, kills thousands of people, devastation, comes back, and the Arab country gives proof to the Indian government, Indian government does not accept. Mullah Omar again, he's not my friend, he told USA, give me proof, and the USA government could not give proof. They shared it with Tony Blair, they shared with Musharraf. Musharraf is saying that I have got enough proof, I have seen the proof. When you're asking the Afghanistan government to give the culprit, the Afghanistan government is telling me, at least give us proof, and they could not give proof to Afghanistan government, and they're sharing it with Tony Blair. It is illogical. That means there's something fishy in the proof. Till today. Till today, Osama bin Laden is prime suspect. It's only hypothesis. The proof should be solid proof. And if they had given solid proof that Osama bin Laden had done it, Afghanistan had to hand over Osama bin Laden. Which they didn't do. If you do something to the Arab country, an Arab country gives proof, and if Indian government objects, then you can go to the International Court of Law. Where is the International Court of Law taking place in case of Osama bin Laden? Where is it? There are international guidelines. Do you know the rule of international guidelines? If suppose there is an extradition policy between the foreign countries, for example, if a person like India and UK have an extradition policy, if any criminal of India does a crime and goes to UK, they can ask for the criminal back. And one of the examples is Nadeem. You know Nadeem, the music director? The Indian government said that he was involved in Gulshan's murder. So when they gave the proof in UK government, in the UK court of law, the UK court of law said your proof is nonsense. They sued the government, Indian government. Indian government had to pay the charges of the advocates of Nadeem. Enough proof they gave. They didn't agree. They say your proof is not valid. Did India wage a war against UK? Why didn't they wage? But the Indian government gave proof at least. There, USA didn't give proof to Afghanistan at all. So even now, if you go to a Saudi land or any Arab land, and if you do something, and if Saudi Arabia gives proof here that you are the culprit, even if the Indian government doesn't agree, Saudi government or any Arab country cannot bombard the 1 billion Indians. It doesn't give permission. Islam doesn't give permission that even if you're the culprit, even if you have killed 1 million people, they can come and catch you if they have the power. They can't bombard the innocent people. They can't do it. It's not allowed in Islam. Same thing you are saying, let's talk about the present scenario in Kashmir, in Gujarat, in Akshadham. I say that whatever may be the background, why those two terrorists entered. In Islam, you cannot destroy the monasteries. You cannot kill the religious people. If anyone goes in a monastery, in a place of worship, in a temple, and killing innocent people, it is against the Quran. It is against the Quran. We have to condemn it. Just because those two people, whatever the reason was, and they got a letter that they believe they came from Tahreek-e-Qisas. Qisas is an Arabic word, which means you can take revenge. And it said it was the cause was because maybe their family was killed. Even if their family was killed, they have no right to kill 44 people. The cause was maybe somebody else, but the action was wrong. Just because somebody killed, if they knew who the person had killed their family members, if they have gone and taken revenge with that person, was separate. How can they kill other 44 people who are innocent? So in Islam also, even if you know who the main culprit is, as I said in my talk in Surah Maida, chapter 5, verse 32, if anyone kills any other human being, unless it be for murder or for creating mischief in the land, it is as though he has killed the whole of humanity. Only if you know who the person is, if he has done mischief and then murder, that is the only way that you can kill him. For no other reason can you kill anyone else. Islam condemns that as though you have killed the whole of humanity. Hope that answers the question.